Okay. I am back in Shroud of the Avatar. I'm in Soul Town. And I'm standing next to the tour guide, who is emoting like crazy. Because he's sad, because there's no Grand Tour this month. I'm going to double click on him anyway. And he's sad to say the Grand Tour has been cancelled. All of the tour guide Ottomans have been kidnapped. The last seen being held by a group of kobolds in the Quell. Or the Kel, I'm not sure. So, not the usual Grand Tour. He's emoting again. I did mention in yesterday's video that avatars can now emote. The tour guide looks like he's heavy into the operatics. So, it's not the now traditional Grand Tour. It's a... it's basically a quest, like you get from other NPCs in the game. They're trying something a bit different, I guess. Still going to involve going to the new areas, although I did go to some of the areas in the last video. The Kel, or whatever, Quell. It's however you want to call it. Because it's not a very long quest, it'll only be the one video. I have watched the Mad Hermit's, as usual, excellent video about doing the quest. His videos tend to be short and to the point, and you know, zoom through the things you need to know. My videos are, this is the real time doing the quest thing, so it's not a step-by-step with edited and speeded up bits. It's we're going to do the quest in real time. Now, it is the middle of the day, so no zombies about. Midday, it says there at the top. Maybe it'll get dark by the time I'm finishing, but I might have to save fighting zombies for another video later in the weekend, or perhaps next week. I'm sure I'll bump into some at some point. So I'm heading along the coast, as per last night. Except this time I know where I'm going, so I am going to cut through at Brightbone Pass. Now I think it's probably worth... I'm going to stop off at Brightbone Pass, just to have a look around. In future releases, not in this release, but in future releases, here it is, look for these rocks in the middle of the road and the snowy peak. Future releases, it's going to be impossible to pass through Brightbone Pass without being pulled into the scene. So it's not a random encounter. But it'll be... So, you know, the price you pay of entering Brightbone Pass is you have to go in. I'm not sure exactly how they're going to work it, because... you know, you could just turn and walk straight out again. Well, actually, it's not quite true that you're necessarily going to be pulled in. You'll be pulled in. Yeah, so you see, you could just walk straight out again. It wouldn't be that difficult. Whether you'll need to walk out on the other side. But yeah, so you see at the top there, there is a flag. Well, I mean, you can't really see it's a flag. There's a glowing red column, which indicates... captured by the enemy. So in order for other players not to be pulled in, someone or a group of people need to head up the pass and capture the control point. Now I'm not going to mess around fighting anyone lower down, I'm just going to go up and capture the control point to demonstrate. By myself I won't be able to hold it, it's just not happening. Now you may remember this pass was a location for a tour guide on a previous quest. He was down the wall there at some point. Right, let's kill the skeleton. There we go. Skeleton archer. We'll take out the archer first. Oh, I missed him. Gotcha, right. So he's dead. So now I'm going to stand by the control point. Oh, the archer's back. Stand by the control point and defeat this large skeleton. There we go. So you see now the control point has the friendly flag. Let's do immolation because I like it. Look at that. If only there were more people around to. Right, archer, you have a fire arrow. Oh dear. Have a fire arrow. Oh dear. Have a fire arrow. There we go. Alright, let's kill all these people. So you see the control point has been captured back now because I'm surrounded by skeletons. But you know. See, we can soon capture it back. Oh. It was a failure. Let's try that again. Ah. So I told you I wouldn't keep it long, because there are hordes of skeletons around, essentially. Let's go after the archer with the fire arrow again. Let's go after everybody else. Let's try healing myself. Oh no. Let's hit F1 and heal myself. I'm gonna die. Oh, I have died. So there you go. I told you I wouldn't keep it. Because I was chatting away to you lot. I missed the fact that I was dying. I did kill quite a lot of skeletons though. I didn't get to loot them because I died. But there are a lot of dead skeletons up there. So that's how control points work. That's going to become a factor in the game from the next release. And that you're going to have to do something with the control point. Or at least you'll get tagged in if it's not under friendly control. In this release, just a curiosity really. Thought I'd show you how it worked. Now there is one thing in this release, it's supposed to be music for when you're dead. Oh, I missed it. Never mind then. So, I'm just punished. So the flag's back to red. So generally the idea is come over with a few friends and battle a whole load of things. Is the idea. I'm gonna leave. It's probably not gonna matter that much. And let's get on with getting the hat for this release. So we're heading back to where I went yesterday. Let's just make sure I get this right. Right, there's the sea. So it always brings you out of the pass facing north, as far as I can tell. Even if you run into the south and then run out again, you always face north. So perhaps the exit there will be tied to one side of the exit, you know, one side on the map, and you'll have to go to the other exit, which I presume is through the control point somehow. Oh yeah, all in all, something a bit different in the game. I'm sure when we see the actual plot and storyline, the pass and fighting way through it will be part of it somehow. So heading over to however you pronounce it. I'm sure someone will let me know at some point. Down this twisty road, across the bridge. There we go. Across the bridge. Right, so you see there's the mine. Where we need to get to is the kobold camp, which I think is up here. There it is, you can see it. Now the kobold camp was a place you could get to from the rift in Owl's Head in previous releases, and now it's actually on the map. You can walk to it, which is pretty cool. So there's quite a few scenes like that that were once, like for instance Brightbone Pass, when back in the day when it was first added to the it wasn't part of this map. You got to it through the Rift at Owl's Head. Now, the Kobold Camp still works the same way as it did before, in that you can wander in here. As long as you don't draw your weapons, they won't attack you. Now we'll see. There are a bunch of tour guides here. Hello, routine not initialized. Please retry. Excellent. Let's go and talk to Captive. Hello, Captive. So, in the Exeter Crag Mines. Don't worry about that. Okay then. Is he emoting away? In the Exeter Crag Mines there is a stupid weapon, air quotes, that they're missing. So all we need to do is find the king. Remember not to draw your sword. Find the king. It's not in here. It must be at the top. That would make sense, wouldn't it? And talk to him. Got some archers. Warriors, archers. Morally superior. Because kobolds never fight wars amongst themselves. Excellent. Powerful kobold weapon was stolen from our armory. Humans cannot use it. Cannot talk to prisoners because they're stupid. Alright, who's this kobold bloke? Excellent. Well, thank you for that. So we'll leg it now. Careful not to start any battles. I already spoke to the prisoners, so we're sorted there. We can just, appreciate the scenery. Is that the way out? I think it might be. Looks promising anyway. I don't know, it's probably the long way around. Let's enjoy the scenery some more. I don't know, like the stars are in this scene. Alright, I've definitely gone the wrong way. Let's leg it back this way. Who knows what might happen. Now, there was a big update tonight. They don't appear to have fixed the cloak disappearing through my butt. There it goes again. But it's, oh, is that the exit over there? Oh dear. Deer, cotton, rabbits. I'm pretty sure I walked in more or less straight in and came in, didn't I? Where's the exit at? Let's harvest some cotton. 94% chance. Oh, meticulous collection. Because I've leveled stuff up, you see? So let's see if we can figure out where the way out is. Because that would be an embarrassing end to the video. So I wander around the camp. For hours and hours. Maybe I should have just kept going the way I was going the first time. Oh, there you go. There's no actual gate. So that explains why it was confusing. So we're going to head back down the hill to the mines themselves. And find this weapon and try not to die. Oh, it's night. I've spent that amount of time messing around. Right, so this way. There's the mines. We're stuck on a tree. There we go, right. Let's have a look in the mines. It's been a pretty warm day in London today, and my computer is humming along quite loudly as a result. It's a bit of warm in my room. So, presumably there's some bad guys near somewhere. Thug! Set fire to him, yeah. Poisoned him, set fire to him. Let's do that. Alright then. Warhammer. So we need to find this gun. Ah, what's that? Non-functional cobalt air cannon. Let's stick it in my inventory. Notes freshly written. After we killed the Barker, what carried this boss asked me to figure out how to make it work, given that it killed six of us. It acts like some kind of magic wand, but none of us has ever seen a wand like this. It won't work no matter what we do. Maybe trade it to a mage because no one buys things not working. Barkers maybe buy it back. This whole thing is stupid, stupid, Barker stupid, boss stupid, wait, someone here will write more later. And then I killed him. So there you go. It's like a story. So we won't explore the mines anymore at this time. Oh, another thug. Oh, he's back. Let's kill him again then. I'm going to set him on fire. Oh, two thugs. Let's immolate him. Now you're all on fire. How do you like them apples? Fizzles. You're on fire. Now you're poisoned. Now you're dead. And still on fire. Right. So we'll loot these. More gold, more warhammers. Let's see if we can find a way out. I think this was the way. Yeah, looks familiar. So, not a lot of fanning around searching for things like the Grand Tours always were in the past. I presume we'll get back to that in the future. I don't know, I mean, I don't know if this is actually better. It's definitely easier. I wonder if they're trying to appease a large number of people that bought the game in the Steam sales recently. Oh, hang on. My armour is damaged. Let's see, which armour is it? Not that, not that, not that. It's the boots. Let's find a repair kit. There we go. Yes. Boots all better now. There we go. Sorry for that interlude. Into the expeditionary camp. So, we go in. We give the gun back, we rescue all the hostages, and become the hero of the whatever, you know, or until the next person comes along and does the thing again. So yes, back in the day when this was still off the owl's head portal, this was a good place to come to get some starter armor. It used to be you look there, there's a blacksmith. Oh, there's a warrior with a big hammer, but there is a blacksmith, and there was just a load of armor and stuff lying around. Hello there. Alright. Item added to your inventory, Kobold Commander Mask. You will still stand bad and talk funny, but you at least will not be so ugly. So there we go. Let's go on a Let's go and put the hat on. Where is it? Kobold Commander Mask. Look at that. Looking good. So we'll do a nice screenshot. There we go. And that'll be it. I presume that someone died right here. Someone got the sword out, I'm guessing. And paid the price. What are these dudes doing over here? Oh, they're just standing around a fire, chilling. I'm just going to head down to where the captives were to see if, in my instance now, they're free or whether they're all still sitting there. Let's have a look. So he's grateful, but he's not going to go anywhere. Let's see if he's got anything more useful to say. No. I wonder if they all say the same thing. Yes, seems like it. So there you go. I'm looking good in my Kobold Commander mask. That was the replacement for the Grand Tour in Shelly Avatar R19. So that'll probably be it for videos for this release. R20 will be out in a month, and complete character wipe for that one. So we'll be trying out the new player experience again. So something to look forward to. Yeah. Easy one this release. Looking good, eh?